actually have been a long partner with FTTH Council Asia Pacific and all other councils as well. And they actually do a research over all the FTTH panorama report for us. So they will be sharing some insights from the statistics, the report we have here. So please, hi, Roman.
Thank you, Rosafi, for giving me the occasion to share a few results of the panorama of this year. So as you were saying, we are doing this panorama in 21 countries for the FTTH Council APAC since 8 years. So I would say that it has been a good year for the market in the Asia-Pacific region. If we look at the figures in terms of subscribers, for example, we reach today more than 368 million subscribers, to be compared to more than half billion FTTH home pass. And the good news is that the growth is good. We have a growth of more than 20% for subscribers and for home pass. And this conducts us to adoption, a take-up rate of nearly 71% in the zone, which is the highest of the world. So it means that when fiber is deployed, people are subscribing, so there is a willingness for adoption of fiber to the home in the region.
Okay, so any countries you are seeing a huge number of growth, or what are the status from the last year?
So if we look first on the number of home passed, for example, so you have two leagues, I would say. One country is really out of the league. It is, of course, China. They are today close to 400 million home passed. And we have, after four other countries, we have more than 10 million home passed. I mean, we have here Japan, South Korea, Indonesia, but also Vietnam in this camp. And we have also today a progression in other countries. We have 10 countries with more than 1 million home passed. And I have to underline that in this camp, we have the Philippines. The Philippines has been the country in the zone experiencing the best growth in terms of home passed. They had a growth of more than 60% in terms of home passed, which is the best growth in the zone. This is one point. And we have to point out that a big country like China is experiencing again a growth of 20% in terms of home pass, which is a great performance.
Okay, so any challenges you see in APAC countries that are different from other regions as you do all the panoramas for all the FTTH councils out there?
Well, some challenges could be the way the network are deployed. We have seen this in many cases today in the conference. There is a lot of aerial deployment in the Asia-Pacific country. So we must be cautious that a future-proof network such as fiber to the home has to be deployed in future-proof way. So I see movement in some countries. For example, we can mention Japan, when there is a plan to put all the aerial deployment in the ground. And I think this movement should accelerate in some countries, because if not, with some messy deployment in aerial way, telco can experience some troubleshooting, and it will be a pity.
Okay. So we have done for the first time the 5G minute panorama this time. So can you brief us some numbers from there? Or any insights from there?
Indeed, we did for the first time for the FTTH Council APAC what we call the mini 4G and 5G panorama. He has started for one point, saying that LTE in APAC has been highly deployed. We know that the most advanced country in terms of LTE rollout has been South Korea or Japan. And starting for this, we know that also the first country in the world to adopt 5G should be here in the Asia-Pacific zone, not to mention countries like Japan or South Korea or even China, already well positioning in 5G. So we decided together to do this mini 5G panorama, because we believe that one of the drivers for fiber adoption will be also 5G. It has been said during this conference, if we want to have short latency 5G services, you have to have a very consistent frontal and backhaul network. And we know that the best backhaul and frontal network will be with fiber to the home. So this research is quite consistent for me for the evolution of FTTH and fiber rollout in the region.
Okay, thank you. So what potential do you see in Asia-Pacific countries, specifically?
In the Asia-Pacific countries, we have several categories of countries. We have the front runners and the pioneers, such as Japan or South Korea and China as a big market. But we have today still a great potential. We can point out, for example, India. India has only, I would say, 2% of the homes passed with fiber. So you can imagine the huge potential of a country of more than 1.3 billion people. But there is other candidates in all the zone. I mentioned already the power of the market here in the Philippines and in Vietnam. But you can add also other country in the southeast part of Asia. We call this the potential of the market. We have to mention here Bangladesh, Laos, Cambodia, Myanmar are for me the next candidate for growth in the APAC region.
Okay, I think we have got enough of information from Roland, so we'd like to thank him for being with us. So thank you, Roland.
My pleasure. Thanks a lot, Mustafi.
Thank you.